and engaging in devotional service 24 hours daily. At the time, the person who had returned from Vrindavan would praise Rupa Sanatan Goswami, the Chaitanya. Just like Prabhupada said, Pujya Brata, again he said, Prabhupada, please tell something about Pujya Brata in Vrindavan. So stop eating, stop sleeping. And Prabhupada was laughing, day and night chant.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare.
Actually, we understand prayer is very powerful. One of the items of devotional service. Depends on how you are praying. Are you praying officially or are you praying crying at heart? Makes a lot of difference. Are you surrender? Half surrender, no surrender. Makes a lot of good. Yes, this is food for thought, you should think. Why you are not getting desired result? There's a reason. God is perfect, you are not perfect. Anybody is perfect here? Anybody is perfect here? Jonathan, you are perfect? At least you are humble, you are honest. That means we have got some hope. Yes? Yeah, in this. You can later make comment or question. Okay.
The Lord instructs Srila Rupa Goswami. Translation.
That means, basically means Prabhupada asking, cut down your eating, sleeping, Baba, and see what you can do, and do more devotional service, especially chanting. Sometimes, the great personality would say, why all this is meeting? Meeting means, conference means resolution. Resolution means, ultimately, no solution. Evolution. Better chat more. And all this meeting feeling make place. Some great personal said, do devotion service.
They carry only one.
And the meaning of chanting, you know. That is from the core of our heart, we feelingly pray, I want to serve you. Prabhupada said, bhakti means devotional service. Devotional service. You have to do something for the pleasure of Krishna as the authorized, as the guru or his representative asking. That is seva. Otherwise, it is not seva. You may be little something towards bhakti. Anyway, that is what Bhakti Siddhanta Thakur said. Go ahead.
They carry only water pots and they wear torn quilts. They always chant the holy names of Krishna and discuss his pastimes. In great jubilation, they also dance.
Prabhupada said that we are Rupa Nuga, followers of Rupa Goswami. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's siksha, he received by the Goswamis, especially disciples. And especially we are among them, followers of Rupa Goswami, Rupa Sanatana Raghunatha Goswami. And what they got, they elaborated. Explained in different books, we will desire when the day will come, we can be eligible, qualified to understand those literature. Rupa Narukunatha Pada, Hivyakuti. Tabe hama buja vase jugalapri, conjugal love. At present, we are thinking, we just understand Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, that is his confusion. What you are teaching to the world? Krishna is the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he is the Supreme Master, we are his eternal servant. Our business is to simply serve with love and devotion. Then detail is there, devotion. Got the detail. But first of all, you should know I am not this body. This is a khet job. That's the khet. Now he is maybe tilling the land. You know. So what tilling means, you saw Krishna Balaram. Balaram has got a plow. That means a guru will help you to plow the land. This land, this is land. Field of activity. As you are cultivating Krishna consciousness just in the land, somebody sow, same land he may be sowing neem seed, and only saying mango seed. Both are sowing, the seeds are different, and the result will come. Huh? How you are watering, how you are taking care, how you fencing, that depends on that. So this is also according to you are getting that sort of bhakti or whatever. Cultivating Krishna consciousness, becoming Krishna consciousness, cultivating material consciousness, becoming materialism. Or something else, becoming sahaja. But now, in the beginning, it starts. Radha Krishna becoming sahaja. It is meant for liberated soul. You are liberated or not liberated. You will know that everything is in Prabhupada's book there. Krishna said, Janisha Swarva Bhutana. The Sat Jagatti Sangja. One has to control his senses. One has to be disciplined. One has to control his senses. Obedient. And he has to know how to successfully, perfectly carry out the instruction of the presence of Krishna. If he does not do, then he cannot go back to God. You said that? But I am simply repeating this. Who was repeated again and again because we forget. Because Krishna consciousness means first hearing very nicely. This is association. Association means seeing Krishna or seeing sadhu means hearing. By hearing you see sadhu, you know sadhu. By hearing, then putting into practice, we then realize Vrindavan. Otherwise, buying a ticket, we are coming in Vrindavan, seeing another village. Yes? Something else you are seeing? But when you Vishayacharya, when you give up sense gratification, Vishayacharya, that is material life, that is material plane. Give up and come to spiritual plane, trying to please Krishna. What Krishna says, what previous Acharya says. Then they Obhagyana from a plane of nescience, very ignorance, you are blind, he opens your eyes so that he can see things as it is. Brahma says, Chintamani, Prakashadma, Kalpa Viksha, Laksha, Viteshu. This is not different. Anybody seeing Kalpa Viksha? Then realizing which Kalpa Viksha? Goswami is realized. So you follow their footprints. As shown, depending on time, circumstances, places, by Prabhupada, see, now you follow. Prabhupada's books, everything is there. All ideal questions answered there. You may have. We have many questions, the ideal questions answered. We can get it, which will help us to become perfect Krishna consciousness.
They engage almost 24 hours daily in rendering service to the Lord.
The same thing Prabhupada is saying. The Goswami is doing only every night under one tree. It's only Ketan, no particular place of residence. Came here. Though he comes from a background, one is chief minister of the Nawab of Bengal. One is finance minister, and they have got so much money association with Mandalapati. That means most aristocratic families, and so much wealth that they kick out all these things. Takta. Kick out all luxurious life, well, divide it among relatives and for the propagation of Krishna consciousness, little kept very much gentle, most oily, most meritless. Living with the bare necessities of life, just to cover private parts of your body, only a little bit like a loincloth, nothing else. Sleeping on the floor, on the tree maybe, 24 hours, 1.5 hours maybe sleeping and doing other things. And eating what? After the whole day, Raghunath Das Goswami, little in a dona, lip cup, he sometimes eat lip cup, like this, boil. And then little, after the whole day, some matha, chach, bojibashi takes. Still now, bojibashi eating simply chapati and chach. So we cannot do, but at least here we do simply rice dal some sort. That's it. And what Prabhupada told us, you don't have to copy their Bhagavad Parshad, but follow the principle, living very simple life. In terms of eating, sleeping, dressing. So you see what they do. Open a kanthasthito. And then what are you doing? In feeling separation from Krishna, always, Radhe Gojalalite, Nanda Sunaha. Where are you, Radharani, Lalita, Vishakha? Are you on the bank of Kalindi, Jamuna, or on the foothills of Giriraj. Govardhan. Where are you? But haven't they seen Krishna? They have seen. And this is the moon. Feeling separation. We have to develop that. We are not feeling, most probably we are feeling separation of something else. Maybe. Object of sense. Let's cultivate that. There is Balaram Guru is holding the plow. Then you can see Krishna. You can realize Krishna how he is playing. In other words, seeing the spirit, the Vrindavan. Vishaya Chariya Kave, Shuddha Harma. When you give up sense gratification, then our heart will be clean. Cheto Dakpana Marjana. Kobe Hama Heva, then you'll be qualified to realize Vrindavan. Yes. They next day when they go to another under another tree, by that time their desire is fulfilled. They used to circumambulate Govardhan. And Sanatana Goswami, though he is now nearly 80 years old, he thought, still he is going. Krishna said, no, he had already achieved perfection, he don't have to do that. It's just like a fight between lovers and the beloved. He want to do, he won't let him. He said, okay, I give you this stone, Govardhan Shila, with my footprints, also print of Bansi, cow's hoof print, all these things. Krishna's footprint. Now you circumambulate. He's still there. In Radha Damodar. And Prabhupada was there. Some say Prabhupada had vision of Prabhupada Goswami. For that night he'll be sleeping. There Prabhupada Goswami has bhajan puti, samadhi. So get his blessing to go to Western world.
They usually sleep only
and
an hour.
And you can tell, where Vrajavasi is coming. So many years. How many years you spent? 10 years. I am not 10 months even in 1 year. No more than me. Yes. Realization.
They usually sleep only an hour and a half. And some days, when they continuously chant the Lord's holy name, they do not sleep at all.
So who lives how many hours? Maximum how many hours sleep will be?
8 hours.
8 hours. Prabhupada said, 6 hours. Don't. So Prabhupada I saw, as I remember, after breakfast, but Prabhupada was not taking, he's thinking still. And after noontime, 1 hour. At night, maybe 11 to 1, 2. So 4 hours. So Prabhupada gave us, you stay 6 hours. An exceptional case of disease.
Sometimes they write transcendental literatures about devotional service. And sometimes they hear about Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and spend their time thinking about the Lord.
Once one of our Prabhupada's disciple asked Prabhupada, Prabhupada, the thinking about the Lord means Krishna said, manmana bhava, always think Krishna. And you said that Krishna playing the flute, Kishore Kishore, Radha Krishna, Krishna. So we are not always thinking, Prabhupada, you know that. Prabhupada said, it doesn't matter. In the absolute plane, Krishna, think of Krishna, most confidential, of course, think of Krishna's service. You are thinking to spread this movement, as Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, yes. Whatever it is, yes, there is your thinking. That's all right.
When the personal associates
of... Maybe Jaya Dita Maharaj, as far as...
When the personal associates of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu would hear of the activities of Rupa and Sanatana Goswamis, they would say, what is wonderful for a person who has been granted the Lord's mercy?
Yes.
Srila Rupa Goswami and Sanatana Goswami had no fixed residence. They stayed beneath a tree for one day only and wrote huge volumes of transcendental literature. They not only wrote books but chanted, danced, discussed Krishna and remembered Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's pastimes. Thus, they executed devotional service. In Vrindavan, there are Prakriti Sahajiyas, who say that writing books or even touching books is taboo. For them, devotional service means being relieved from these activities. Whenever they are asked to hear a recitation of Vedic literature, they refuse, saying, "What business do we have reading or hearing transcendental literatures? They are meant for neophytes." They pose themselves as too elevated or to exert energy for reading, writing and hearing. However, pure devotees under the guidance of Srila Rupa Goswami reject this Sahajiya philosophy. It is certainly not good to write literature for money or reputation, but to write books and publish them for the enlightenment of general populace is real service to the Lord. That was Srila Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati's opinion, and he specifically told his disciples to write books. He actually preferred to publish books rather than establish temples. Temple construction is meant for the general populace and neophyte devotees. But the business of advanced and empowered devotees is to write books, publish them and distribute them widely. According to Bhaktisiddhanta Saraswati Thakur, distributing literature is like playing on a great mridanga. Consequently, we always request members of the International Society for Krishna Consciousness to publish as many books as possible and distribute them widely throughout the world. By thus following in the footsteps of Srila Rupa Goswami, one can become a Rupanuga devotee.
One's great personality, a devotee, and giving love of Godhead and fulfilling the prophecy of the Lord, he said, "My Guru once was so disturbed, seeing when he was making temple and others, the disciples, followers are fighting, who will stay in the best room with Mahaprabhu building?" He said, he told one of his disciples, favorite disciple, he said, "Look, whenever you get money, you print as many books in as many languages as possible and distribute profits. I'm so disturbed making this temple now, even thinking, I will stay in this room, I will stay in this room. I'd rather feel like this temple is not so important. Feel like taking all these marbles out and sell it and then bring more books and distribute." That is real Midam. That is real Sankirtan. To all throughout the world. Which, that is Bihat Midanga. Small Midanga is few person can. Here and chanting. And Bihat Midanga is printing books, distributing. Prabhupada said, this ISKCON is like a whole movement is like a preaching movement, like a distributing. It has many books, as many languages. So Prabhupada told, these people, those are Sahajya, overnight want to copy the Goswamis, putting on clothes, they are not Paramahamsa. See what they left at home, again they are associating those things. So Prabhupada said, "I talked to them before, I find, no, my Guru Maharaj is right. So you should become bhakta, and he's saying to ask others to become bhakta, bring others to Krishna consciousness. They say it is not necessary to preach. You just sit down here, do japa." That is Gostan. Prahlad Maharaj wants that, "I don't want to go back to Godhead alone. Why not make as many people are suffering, so they don't know they are suffering. So we have to make them Krishna conscious. We have to bring them lotus feet of Krishna." That is much Mahabhadana. That is more broad-minded. Sign of broad-minded. It's not how I can selfish. This is called Gostano. Gostano means bring others. There is a lot of speed of Krishna, chant, glorify Krishna's name, Krishna's form, Krishna's beauty, for the first time, there is no chant. Good.
Srila Rupa Goswami has personally spoken about the mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu in his auspicious introduction to his book, Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. "Although I am the lowest of men and have no knowledge, the inspiration to write transcendental literatures about devotional service has been mercifully bestowed upon me. Therefore, I am offering my obeisances at the lotus feet of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, who has given me the chance to write these books." For 10 days, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu stayed at Prayag and instructed Rupa Goswami, empowering him with the necessary potency. Purport, Srila Prabhupada. This is a confirmation of the statement, Krishna Shakti Bina Nahe Tara Pravartana. Unless one is specifically empowered by Supreme Personality of Godhead, he cannot spread the Krishna consciousness movement. An empowered devotee sees and feels himself to be the lowest of men, for he knows that whatever he does is due to the inspiration given by the Lord in the heart. This is confirmed by Lord Sri Krishna in the Bhagavad Gita. Tesham Shraddha Yuktanam Bhajatam Pritipurvakam Dadami Buddhi Yogam Tam Yenamam Upayantite. To those who are constantly devoted to serving me with love, I give the understanding by which they can come to me. To be empowered by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, one has to qualify himself. To be empowered by the Supreme Personality of Godhead, one has to qualify himself. This means that one must engage 24 hours daily in the loving devotional service of the Lord. The material position of a devotee doesn't matter because devotional service is not dependent on material considerations. In his earlier life, Srila Rupa Goswami was a government officer and a grihastha. He was not even a brahmachari or sannyasi. He associated with malechas and yavanas, but because he was always eager to serve, he was a qualified recipient for the Lord's mercy. A sincere devotee can therefore be empowered by the Lord regardless of his situation. In the preceding verse from the Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, Srila Rupa Goswami has described how he was personally empowered by the Lord. He further states in the Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu, Iha jasya hare dasye karmana manasa gira nikhilasu apyavasthasu jivan mukta sauchite. A person acting in the service of Krishna with his body, mind and words is a liberated person even in the material world, although he may be engaged in many so-called material activities. To keep oneself free from material contamination and attain the Lord's favor, one must be sincerely engaged to render service to the Lord. This is the only qualification necessary. As soon as one is favored by the mercy of the spiritual master and the Lord, one is immediately given all the power necessary to write books and propagate the Krishna consciousness movement without being hampered by material considerations. Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu said, My dear Rupa, please listen to me. It is not possible to describe devotional service completely. Therefore, I am just trying to give you a synopsis of the symptoms of devotional service. The ocean of the transcendental mellows of devotional service is so big that no one can estimate its length and breadth. However, just to help you taste it, I am describing but one drop. In this universe, there are limitless living entities in 8,400,000 species, and all are wandering within this universe. The length and breadth of the living entity is described as 1/10,000th part of the tip of a hair. This is the original subtle nature of the living entity. If we divide the tip of a hair into 100 parts and then take one of these parts and divide it again into 100 parts, that very fine division is the size of but one of the numberless living entities. They are all chitkana, particles of spirit, not matter. If we divide the tip of a hair into 100 parts and then take one part and divide this into another 100 parts, that 10,000th part is the dimension of the living entity. This is the verdict of the chief Vedic mantras. Lord Krishna says, among minute particles, I am the living entity. The unlimited living entities can be divided into two divisions, those that can move and those that cannot move. Among living entities that can move, there are birds, aquatics and animals. Although the living entities known as human beings are very small in quantity, that division may still be further subdivided. For there are many uncultured human beings like Malaysians, Pulindas, Baudhas and Sabaras. Among human beings, those who are followers of the Vedic principles are considered civilized. Among these, almost half simply give lip service while committing all kinds of sinful activities against these principles. Such people do not care for the regulative principles.
They understand who said, I belong to this fate. But actually, they are doing sinful activities.
Among the followers of the Vedic knowledge, most are following the process of fruitive activity and distinguishing between good and bad work.
Karmi, sakam.
Out of many such sincere fruitive actors, there may be one who is actually wise. Out of many millions of such wise men, one may actually become liberated, mukta. And out of many millions of such liberated persons, a pure devotee of Lord Krishna is very difficult to find. In Srimad Bhagavatam 10:32, it is said that due to their poor fund of knowledge, the jnanis are not actually liberated. They simply think that they are liberated. The perfection of knowledge culminates when one comes to the platform of knowing the Supreme Personality of Godhead, Brahmeti, Paramatmeti, Bhagavaniti, Saptati. The absolute truth, Satya Vastu, is described as Brahman, Paramatma and Bhagavan. Knowledge of impersonal Brahman and the Super Soul is imperfect until one comes to the platform of knowing the Supreme Personality of Godhead. It is therefore clearly said in this verse, Koti Mukta Madhye Durlab Eka Krishna Bhakta. Those who search after the knowledge of impersonal Brahman or localized Paramatma are certainly accepted as liberated. But due to their imperfect knowledge, they are described in Srimad Bhagavatam as Vimukta Maninaha. Since their knowledge is imperfect, their conception of liberation is imperfect. Perfect knowledge is possible when one knows the Supreme Personality of Godhead. This is supported by Lord Krishna in the Bhagavad Gita. Bhuktaram yagya tapasam sarvaloka maheshwaram suhridam sarvabhutanam gyatva mam shantim richati. A person in full consciousness of me, knowing me to be the ultimate beneficiary of all sacrifices and austerities, the Supreme Lord of all planets and demigods, and the benefactor and well-wisher of all living entities, attains peace from the pangs of material miseries. Research is going on for the karmis, jnanis and yogis, but until the search is complete, no one can attain peace. Therefore, Bhagavad Gita says, Gyatva mam santim richati. One can actually attain peace when he knows Krishna. This is described in the next verse. Because a devotee of Lord Krishna is desireless, he is peaceful. Fruitive workers desire material enjoyment. Jnanis desire liberation. And yogis desire material opulence. Therefore, they are all lusty and cannot be peaceful.
Lusty.
The devotee of Lord Krishna has no desire other than serving Krishna. Even so-called liberated persons are full of desires. Fruitive actors desire better living accommodations, and jnanis want to be one with the Supreme Yogi, with the Supreme. Yogis desire material opulence. Yogis desire material opulence, yogic perfections and magic. All of these non-devotees are lusty, kami. Because they desire something, they cannot have peace. The peace formula is given by Krishna in Bhagavad Gita. Bhuktaram yagya tapasam sarvaloka maheshwaram Suridam Sarvabhutanam Gyatva Mam Santimirchati. One who simply understands that throughout the entire universe, Krishna is the supreme enjoyer and beneficiary of all kinds of sacrifices, penances and austerities, which should be performed only to attain his devotional service. That Krishna is the supreme being and thus the proprietor of all the material worlds, and that Krishna is the only friend who can actually do good to all living entities. Suhridam Sarvabhutanam. One who understands these three principles about Krishna immediately becomes desireless and therefore peaceful. A Krishna Bhakta knows that his friend and protector in all respects is Krishna, who is able to do anything for his devotee. Krishna says, Kanteya pratijanihi name bhakta pranasyati. O son of Kunti, declare it boldly that my devotee never perishes. Since Krishna gives this assurance, the devotee lives in Krishna and has no desire for personal benefit. The background for devotee is that is the all good himself. Why should the devotee aspire for something good for himself? His only business is to please the Supreme by rendering as much service as possible. A Krishna Bhakta has no desire for his own personal benefit. He is completely protected by the Supreme. Avashya Lakshive Krishna Vishwash Palana. Bhaktivinoda Thakur says that he is desireless because Krishna will give him protection in all circumstances. It is not that he expects any assistance from Krishna. He simply depends on Krishna just as a child depends on his parents. The child does not know how to expect service from his parents, but he is always protected nevertheless. This is called niskam, desirelessness. Although kamis, gyanis and yogis fulfill their desires by performing various activities, they are never satisfied. A karmi may work very hard to acquire $1 million, but as soon as he gets $1 million, he desires another million. For the karmis, there is no end of desire. The more the karmi gets, the more he desires. The gyanis cannot be desireless because their intelligence is unsound. They want to merge into the Brahman effulgence, but even though they may be raised to that platform, they cannot be satisfied there. There are many gyanis or sannyasis who, after taking sannyas and giving up the world as false, return to the world to engage in politics or philanthropy or to open schools and hospitals. This means that they could not attain the real Brahman, Dhamma Satyam. They have come down to the material platform to engage in philanthropic activity. Thus, they again cultivate desires. And when these desires are exhausted, they desire something different. Therefore, the jnani cannot be niskam, desireless. Nor can the yogis be desireless, for they desire yogic perfections in order to exhibit some magical feats and gain popularity. People gather around these yogis and the yogis desire more and more adulation. Because they misuse their mystic power, they fall down again into the material platform. It is not possible for them to become niskam, desireless. The conclusion is that only the devotees who are simply satisfied in serving the Lord can actually become desireless. Therefore, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu says here, Krishna Bhakta Niskam. Since the Krishna Bhakta, the devotee of Krishna, is satisfied with Krishna, there is no possibility of fall down.
Any question? Most of the people are actually, 98% are Kuru. He is working hard, very, he has got unlimited desire. Want to enjoy the fruit of his life. That is most of all world. Maybe some are little gyani or yogi, but still they have got also some desire material. Gyani means you want to become God or Mahajyoti. Yogi means you want to see, you want to have some attractive yogic power, opulence, like he becomes smaller than the smallest, lighter than the lightest. There are many other movies, many years. Prabhupada used to tell one story that Prabhupada's house when Jogi used to come, Prabhupada's father's friend, he liked to, you know, welcome him. And he said, simply, he can easily, within a short time, can go far away, hundreds of miles, in a short time. Then another story was telling. But they don't give him, Prabhupada said, we don't give him body to go with power.